I want to keep this video very short, all about the oscillator circuit that I published yesterday and today, 1 September 2021. The secret was that we had here an unseen coil between the gate and the drain. That meant that this circuit started to oscillate. I tested a few types of other MOSFETs that I had in my stock. Some worked, some did not work. And here is the test setup. This is the coil that's now connected between the gate and the drain. That is a wide lead. And I stick into that coil this ferrite rod. So this is the test setup, and I take it out and look how high the frequency goes. There are a few important things at first. The first conclusion was that I tested it with different coils, my test coils. They go from 10 microhenry to 820 microhenry. In that case, the oscillator works on 4.7 volts, that's important to tell, between 1.1 megahertz megacycles and 139 kilocycles. That's the frequency band. And of course, these test coils, they are here. Test coils. And they look this way. This were the test coils. So instead of that piece of wire of 10 centimeter, or this coil that I showed, this coil here, I use these quite high inductance coils. Anyway, that was the first conclusion. And then the transistors, the MOSFETs that worked and that didn't work. Green means that it works. And I've sticked in a ferrite rod in all these cases. I've also indicated the supply voltage, and I will tell more about that, because we see kind of the same phenomenon when the supply voltage changes between 4 and 18 volts. It didn't work on voltages lower than 4 volts or 4.2 volts. It also stopped working sometimes, not always, when the voltage got too high, higher than 18 volts. So these MOSFETs worked. This one didn't work. This one also didn't work. The IRFP440 worked, but only in a limited voltage range. And this is was the best, most usable MOSFET for this experiment and this circuit. Pure luck that I used this transistor in my experiments. This MOSFET also works, the 75545P. And this the IRFZ46N, and that's now in the circuit here. The IRFZ46N, and I can demonstrate very good what happens in this type of oscillator. So first back to the bare circuit. The outcoupling capacitors are 100 picofarad to the counter and 1 microfarad to the scope. And here is the coil, or a piece of wire of 10 centimeters. What happens is perhaps interesting to show. The voltage is now on 4.6 volt. There's almost no current taken out. And this is the test setup with that MOSFET that I mentioned. And it works now on 3 megahertz. With that ferrite rod in that tiny coil, take the ferrite rod out, and the amplitude goes down very substantially. Frequency goes up, and I've already tested it with a variable capacitor, tuning capacitor, parallel to that coil, and I could vary the frequency in a range of 1 megahertz. So that's interesting. And I've done that with this Fionic capacitor. And it has a capacitance of approximately 40 picofarad. Anyway, interesting to show is also that, I will amplify it a little bit more here, that we, when we change the supply voltage, we see in almost all cases this deterioration of the wave. Typical deterioration with all the MOSFETs that I tested. Now we are on 15 volts, we are on 19 volts, and I go back now, 17 volts, 12 volts, 7.6, 5, 4.6, and on that low voltage, we have the best waveform. So when you want to make an oscillator with it, the advised voltage is approximately 5 volts. You can perhaps see what happens in the terms of frequency change when I lift up the supply voltage. Now it's 5 volts. Now it's 10 volts. The frequency does not change so much, only the waveform gets deteriorations. Strange oscillating in and out, sub-oscillations, etc., etc. Doesn't have to be a problem. So that was all to tell. Thanks for watching. Again, thanks for all the comments that I had on this circuit. And this is the best MOSFET, but now I'm testing another MOSFET, and it is this one, the IRFZ46N.